Now, we were talking about Thoth before. What are the Emerald Tablets?
So the Emerald Tablets of Thoth the Atlantean, and I like to refer to this as the Doriol translation, which was a channeled text that came in the early 20th century. And this is a record and a story of Thoth. It's a story of Thoth. I've read it more than 200 times. Mm-hmm. And every time I read it or listen to it on audio tapes, I get something entirely new from it. So it has some quality to it that is transcendent. And it tells a story of Thoth as an Atlantean and how his people and his civilization was basically at the end. It was beyond their apex. And they knew they were going into a period of darkness. And so basically he left us these emerald tablets in order to find them and raise our consciousness when the world was ready for that consciousness to raise. And it tells a story also, and he talks about it in the Emerald Tablets as having been associated with the pyramid, right? And the Great Pyramid is the pyramid of Earth life force. And that pyramid, he claims in the Emerald Tablets, to have been built by him. He says, built I the Great Pyramid. Mm-hmm. And he says it several places, builded I the Great Pyramid. And then he challenges the reader to lay in the sarcophagus and the mysteries will be revealed to you. So I took that to heart and I went to Egypt and I laid in the sarcophagus. I've spent 13 nights in the Great Pyramid now.
Wow.
And it has been some of the most transcendent experiences of my entire life.
What happens? What happens to you?
Well, first of all, you realize that the Great Pyramid is like a musical instrument.
Right. So the vibration, there's vibrations. You can feel the vibration.
Yeah. As soon as you go in, there's a thing called the antechamber. Right. Mm-hmm. So when you go past the Grand Gallery, so there's a 26 degree angle ascent into the King's Chamber area. So you go past the Great Step, which is the final step under the apex of the Great Pyramid. And then you go through this little corridor that's a crouch space that's about 39 inches high. It's about 1 meter high. And as you walk through there, there's two little antechambers. There's a very small antechamber, and then there's a larger antechamber. So the antechamber that's really small, it's only wide enough that my shoulders will fit inside of it. So you stand there and I can fit probably with about 1 inch clearance on both sides. And if you find the right resonance frequency in there, which is 117 hertz, mm-hmm. right? Which the Great Pyramid is 11 over 7. That's the base to the height. Mm-hmm. So 117 and 11.7 squared is 137. And that's the number of times the sarcophagus will fit inside the King's Chamber. And that's a very important mathematical constant, which is called alpha. And that math constant is the separation between light and darkness, called the electron coupling constant. Even the famous physicist himself, Richard Feynman, refers to it as the most mysterious number that we have, because it's the threshold of where light will emit or be absorbed from an electron.
Hmm.
Okay, so it's literally separation of light from darkness. Now, so if you go in through this little crawl space, it's only 39 inches high, about 7 or 8 feet into it, you can stand up and you find this resonance frequency of 117 hertz, which is just like,
are you hearing it? Or
just like that. Else? You feel it, because then the whole chamber, you're standing in there, goes, wah. Right. It's like this resonance goes, wah, and it shakes the hell out of you. And you go, whoa, what is this? It's almost like that little chamber is where you sage yourself. It's like a saging. It's like a vibrational clearing to cleanse you before you go into the King's Chamber,
mm-hmm.
right? So what I do is I'll have people come into that. I'll be standing there. I'll tap them on the back when they start crawling by me, because it's only about 4 feet wide this way also. And I say, stand up. And then they stand up. They're like, oh, I can stand up in here. And then I do that to them, you know. They're like, wah. And then they go into the next antechamber and there's less resonance in there. And then once you've done that, then you go into the King's Chamber. And then when you lay in the sarcophagus, you can resonate at the same frequency, that same humming sound. Mm-hmm. Just like that. You don't have to do more and you don't have to do it louder. And once you do, if you're laying in the sarcophagus, just as if you're standing up in the antechamber, you feel the entire pyramid's force come on like an engine. It starts going wah, 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 like super loud, like super loud. You've got to experience it. You have to experience it. You got this look on your face like, what the fuck? So
you do it. I'm dying to go, man. I'm dying to go.
Yeah, no, it's the most amazing experience you'll ever have. I can tell you that. And a lot of people have had incredible experiences in there.
Is it, I mean, can it be equivalent of a psychedelic experience sometimes, depending on why you're sleeping there at night?
Well, first of all, I've never slept in the pyramid. I've spent 13 nights in there. I think I've done it more than anyone I know, but I've never slept. So I don't sleep inside there. I'm awake because we're discovering stuff and all the mysteries are hidden all over the walls, like literally all over the walls and the mathematics of the architecture. So if you're interested in this, there's a new film that we just made called Giza, the Holy Grail of Geometry. Mm-hmm. And it's on YouTube right now. And we just launched it about a week or so ago. But basically, it tells the geometric relationship we found with Metatron's cube that then defines the entire Giza plateau. And that all three pyramids are built off of the same design that we think was done at the exact same time. The story of, you know, Khufu and Menkaure and Khafre. So Khufu is the grandfather. Then the son was Khafre. And then the grandchild was Menkaure. And they all had different sized pyramids. And everyone thinks that it was because, you know, somehow Menkaure had less money. He'd like somehow frittered away the fortune of the family. It just doesn't really fly, right? Mm-hmm. All three pyramids were built together. They're based on the Orion belt, you know, within the Orion constellation. And their orientation, both in an aerial view dimension as well as looking at it from the ground, is all tied to this Metatron's cube relationship. So this is the first solid evidence that we have, and it's unequivocal mathematically. That's the beautiful part about it. It's the first solid evidence we have that Metatron or Thoth or Enoch or Hermes, Thrace Majestis, had a hand in building the pyramid on a centralized plan, and the entire Giza plateau is based on that plan, which then upends a lot of the narrative that we have, because there's no way that it would have been built then over more than 100 years, right? They would have been built with the same plan in mind at the same time.
Faster than 100 years.
Much faster.
To watch the full video, click on the link below, and don't forget to subscribe.